When we think about construction before modern technology, we imagine people chopping down trees with axes, sanding down the wood by hand, and hoisting it into position with the help of their families. But how did they plan their spaces without paper? How did they know how much material they needed without a computer? How did they measure for cuts without rulers? Hi everyone, my name is Ken. Welcome to This House. Today we will be answering all of these questions as we discover the lost art of the daisy wheel. Situated in Defiance, Missouri, is a vernacular-style house known as the Hayes House, from the early 1800s with proportions that make it truly unique to its site. The house's design doesn't follow any formal measurement systems, which has made it a very curious example of vernacular construction. If it weren't for one clue carved into a door, the construction methods would continue to be a mystery. But thankfully, we can unravel this house's secrets by understanding how the carving played into its design. What we are looking at now is known as a daisy wheel. The daisy wheel, sometimes called a hexafoil, is a design with six-fold dihedral symmetry composed from six petals arranged radially around a central point, often shown enclosed in a circle. This design can be found dating back to the Bronze Age in Europe in both architecture and in art. To get this shape, you would start by drawing a circle with a compass, then draw a series of overlapping circles intersecting with the midpoint of the original circle until you end up with this image. Now that we have a daisy wheel, we can figure out how exactly this house was designed. Using the inherent geometry of the wheel, we can see that the pitch of the roof and the proportions of the walls fit neatly within the expanded grid created by the daisy wheel. To figure out how much stone was needed, one simply had to count the number of circles vertically and horizontally, and this would tell them how much surface area was needed. To figure out how much wood was needed for the roof trusses, one simply had to count the number of circles diagonally, and this would tell them how long each roof truss should be. Now that we know this, we can see the geometry come to life as we look at the Hayes House, the pitch of its roof, and its window placement. Thank you all for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I'll see you next time on This House.